Good evening and welcome to The Checkpoint right here on Urban TV. My name is Nicholas Wasanja. If it had by any chance rained today evening, being in Kampala would be unbearable because of the floods that would distort movement and our livelihoods. We are seeing floods in Kasese, bringing down bridges, distorting lives, bringing down houses, and people are living in sorrow. People that are living on the lake shores are equally not happy with the environment because the water is building up and it is evicting them virtually. On The Checkpoint tonight, our discussion is going to center around environment and the law. And to discuss this is a veteran politician and a lawyer, Honorable Kenny Luchamzi, the man. Welcome to the
Thank
show.
Thank you very much. I'm also the president of the Conservative Party.
Yes, he's also the long-serving president of the Conservative Party. Honorable, you served in Parliament for over a decade, and I would say for the largest chunk of your service, you were the shadow minister for the environment.
Yes, I was.
Before we delve into the issue of environmental degradation, one would like to know what draws you to the environment.
Well, I am a great lover of the environment. I have got also a record of support for supporting the environment. I was the founder secretary general of the Wildlife Clubs of Uganda.
Yes,
I started it. And it is still on. It has lost the strength and the gas it used to have, but it is still living under the command of the Ministry of Tourism and Wildlife. And therefore, when I reached Parliament, it became important for me to pursue the line over which I had a rich background. And I did very well. Many things changed because of my presence in Parliament. For example, the aspect of fighting the water hyacinth without disaster. Government had planned to spray Lake Victoria, Lake Choga, and the Nile waters with the toxic chemicals like dichlorid, like glyphosate, like 2,4-D. My God. And the former vice president of Uganda nearly slapped me because I made it difficult for government to engage into the spray of the innocent waters with the toxicity. And I think one of my achievements in the process was winning a medal, the Eastern Central Africa Environmental Leadership Medal. Predominantly thanking me for fighting the use of toxicity to eliminate the water weed, as well as fighting the use of DDT in the fight against malaria.
You've highlighted the things you did to fight for the environment, but still your viewer would like to know what motivated you to, for example, fight the use of DDT? What motivated you to moot a very spirited fight against the giveaway of Mabira? What is it that you hold dear to the environment?
I hold dear to...
Welcome back from that very short break. You're still watching The Checkpoint with me, Nicholas Wasanja. Our guest tonight is Honorable John Ken Luchamzi, the man, an environmentalist, a renowned environmentalist. And we are speaking environment and the law. Honorable, the president recently, while addressing the nation, said he had sanctioned dilating water stoppers to both former Owen Falls dams. From your perspective, would you feel this is a right decision to offer a solution to these rising water levels?
What did he propose?
He said, and I would quote, sanctioned dilating water stoppers
release.
At both, yes, release water of water stoppers at both former Owen Falls dams. Would in your perspective, would you think this would be a good solution to the water, to the rising water?
There must be collaboration between the electricity body and the government. so that they don't release the water at random. Mm. They must measure the perspectives of control in a scientific manner so that they don't do it at random. They have been doing it at random without notifying the other parties.
The other parties.
Yes. But a lot of scuffle happening on Lake Victoria around the Owen Falls was as a result of a mistake made by the Energy Ministry to position Kira Dam immediate to the location of Narubari. The experts advised, I'd already declared that the spacing was too near. And that is why Kira Dam has never functioned well. Our hope is now in Bujagari. But Bujagari also, I think you know historically that I had stopped it when I wrote to the president of the World Bank because they had accumulated the costs too much that too much. You and your children and ours would suffer a big financial penalty in terms of payment. But the World Bank responded, and I think President Museveni has been hard condemning me. But I think I should be thanked because after notifying that there was a big error made, I think he had to go to the Aga Khan where he got the money. But as we speak now, the Bujagari Dam does not belong to Uganda. Until after 25 years have passed.
Probably.
So the best they can do now, if they are realistic about the funds from oil, the funds from oil can pay off Aga Khan so that we resume trend of making electricity affordable.
Affordable. Yes, that's where I was going, Honorable, that many of the people wonder, we have the president, we have all these dams and more are still being constructed, but why is the electricity cost still high?
Electricity costs are still high because of being too ambitious to acquire dams without spending any money through our local budget. We have tended to think that every development of a dam must necessarily be development fund from borrowed money.